Tonight, Vengeance Unlimited returns.
We live in a world where people can kill someone and get a book deal out of it.
People who think that innocent and not guilty are the same thing. People who treat justice like some sort of business. Well, I've got my own business. It's called Vengeance Unlimited.
No! No! No!
Yes. Yes. Oh, yes.
You won't find him in the yellow pages. But when you've got nowhere else to turn, Mr. Chappell will find you.
You don't have any more problems. They all belong to me now.
He has a price.
What's the catch?
My fee, $1 million.
Has anyone ever actually paid you this million?
Anything's possible.
So you said $1 million bucks.
How about instead, you just owe me a favor?
Here we go with this favor thing again.
I mean, everybody owes you a favor.
Yeah.
What do you want?
I need you to find a guy.
I want you to plant that.
I have to get in the records room.
I'm gonna need you for the next 18 hours.
Am I gonna wish I'd given you $1 million bucks?
He has a friend.
About that favor. I'll be sending a friend of mine over, and I'd like you to cooperate with her, and then we'll be even. You work for the DA.
I schlep files, I get paid peanuts, and I'm always missing days to, you know, do things with you.
Oh my goodness.
He has a rule.
No guns.
And he always has a plan.
So what's the plan?
I want to scare them. Right down to their busted browns.
Is this supposed to scare me?
Oh, what the hell? I mean, I'd like to give it a try.
He was an FBI agent. I mean, he was nuts.
He was a hitman.
He bugs me.
He was a reporter.
I sell diapers.
I could smell that on him.
You're gonna hit me again, aren't you?
Yes. Yes, I am, JJ.
You go ahead and call me irresponsible. I admit I am unreliable, but it is undeniably true that I'm irresponsibly mad for you.
I shouldn't have to work this hard.
I've dealt with this kind of trash my whole life.
You'll end up in jail or dead.
I don't care what happens to me.
Have you ever been beaten half to death by wooden rakes?
I sat through the English patient.
This is nice. Now I'm insufficient?
I am not insufficient.
At least I wouldn't be if you didn't keep slapping me with charges.
What do I want to do?
You know.
Oh.
You really shouldn't let people stand this close to you when you're at an ATM machine.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
No, Dave, because I promised them the entire ad campaign by the end of the week. But I promised. I can't.
sorry?
General Romano, Tenagua, El Salvador, June 23rd, 1990. You were there.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I was there, Colonel Ponce.
Get away here.
Gutierrez, Richard Gutierrez, you have me mistaken with somebody else.
No, you and General Romano, you killed my uncle, my mother, my sister.
Or perhaps at a family reunion.
Him 8 years ago, Coronel Oscar Ponce, and this is General Romano. He gave the orders. Coronel Ponce carried them out.
Why kill unarmed villagers?
We were a threat to the U.S. government. Our cries for help were heard by those that your government didn't like. So they used our own army to keep us silent. Nothing is more silent than death.
You said June 23rd, 1990?
Yes.
Elections that day?
How did you know that?
Well, I know that they were canceled.
Yes. You hear a noise in your house, and there's a man in your sister's bedroom, and she's screaming, and you want to call the police, but you can't, because it is the police. It is the police. I hid under the floor. And I listened as my sister was... You said you could help.
Oh, I will.
I want a gun.
No guns.
Why not?
You won't even be involved.
That's always the deal. I don't understand.
Ponce, Romano. I'll get him myself.
Get? How?
He just will. He's very creative.
And while you're doing this, I'm hiding under the floor again, covering my ears?
Elena, I wasn't there. But I know how you feel. That's the problem. You feel. These men don't. Ponce has already seen your face. He's expecting you. If you're ever lucky enough to get close to him again, you'll end up in jail. Or dead.
I don't care what happens to me. No more hiding.
Did you pay the check?
I tried. They cut up my credit card. Aren't you gonna go after her?
They cut up your credit card?
She's getting a cab. Go, go, go.
I thought you worked for the DA.
I schlep files. I get paid peanuts. And plus, I'm always missing days to, you know, with you. Plus, I have rent. I have a student loan. I have car payments. She's gone. What are we gonna do?
Nothing.
You're not going to just let her go on the street and find this guy on
her. She said no.
She is going to get killed.
Horse, water, drink.
Did I miss a memo? Now you only take jobs that are easy or jobs that fit into your schedule.
I don't help people that say no.
You make this up as you go along.
You think so?
There are no rules in the Batcave, so just invent some clause that is going to allow you to step in.
Does this mean I'm paying the check?
What do you want?
Casey.
Hey, that's mine!
Jeepers!
Get the hell out of my car before I call.
Look, we're worried about you. Just think of this as an intervention. Come on, just breathe. Just breathe. Wow, this is no fun.
Tough love never is.
Corre, corre.
call it in motel. The basement wing. It's actually the only occupied room at the end of a very long hall.
You kidnapped me.
Technically, but if you kind of take the big picture view of this, we're actually trying...
Where's the phone?
Mr. Chapel removed it.
Unlock this door!
He has the only key.
Oh, you're lying.
Elena?
Get me out of here! Somebody help me!
Somebody is.
Did I say the wrong thing?
Ponce and Romano?
You know letting those guys in the country was a presidential mandate?
So was Watergate.
I was not involved. I was against the whole Latin American policy from the beginning, funding these guys, sneaking them into the country afterwards.
That's a good little speech, Joe.
That we've had no contact with them since they've hit U.S. soil. Romano could be anywhere, under any name.
How much money do you think those two characters managed to smuggle in?
According to the file, $3 or $4 million between them.
Cash?
Diamonds. That was always Romano's thing. Keep your money in stones, keep the stones within reach in case you have to get out in a hurry.
Yeah, that's very smart. Is this inconvenient for you?
Well, actually, yeah, kind of.
Well, so was that favor I did for you. Remember that little problem you had with the Samoans? I nearly lost a hearing in my left ear because of that.
Yeah. To be perfectly honest with you, you scare me.
Really?
Yeah. You have this way about you. It's, unsettling. Like what you're doing right now. This staring. But could you stop?
When you start.
What?
Being more appreciative.
All the survivors in our database will be there, where you want them, when you want them. I'm arranging it personally.
You know, Joe, I have to say, you still seem a bit uneasy.
Okay. What exactly do you have planned?
Ponce and Romano's worst nightmare.
Which is?
The right to face their accusers.
Elena Ameo. Seeing Ponce, it was sheer luck. So, you know, just take him and then walk away because you will never find Romano. He's gone. The guys who brought him to the country don't even know where he is.
June 23rd, 1990. Saturday. You remember what you were doing?
Pardon me?
You're probably sitting on the couch with your wife and kids. Drinking a beer, watching a ball game. I bet you took some family snapshots. That's another one. Wife, kids. Ponce, Romano, same Saturday. If you're born up here, you don't have to think about stuff like that. If you're born down there, you never forget it. I want to nail those two.
What can I do to help?
Scare them. Right down to their busted browns.
For them, for Ponce, and for Romano.
I'm gonna get you some water. You want some water?
Thanks.
Who are you?
Diamante Security. This is nice. You like to make people feel safe. So do I.
Heather. Who are you?
how I got in here, considering all the fancy alarms you got all over this joint. Yeah. Ought to give you some clue, Oscar.
My name is Richard Gutierrez.
Save that for the Rotary Club. I'm one of the good guys, one of your friends. You could talk to me. My name's Chapel, and I almost beat your record.
Record?
El Sal, 50 kills. Remember that lady the army had with the funny little needle? She gave all of us these nifty little souvenirs. I scored 100. I was an advisor over there. Trained you guys, got you guns. I might have beat your record if they hadn't brought the curtain down in 92.
What do you want?
You. Safe. Take a look at this file. All those faces, they're here now, United States. And they want you and General Romano dead. Trouble is, we can't find him. If we can't find him, we can't help him. That's why we need you. Have you seen anybody there lately?
This woman.
When?
Yesterday. There was an awkward moment.
Well, unless you killed her, then I guess you got yourself in a world of trouble.
Mr. Chapel, you seem determined to put the fear of God in me.
Yeah. How am I doing?
I stopped believing in God a long time ago. Experience would indicate that General Romano and I can take care of ourselves. If you know what I mean.
State Department, excuse me. Excuse me. Joe Melvoy, State Department. I'm very sorry. This wasn't supposed to happen. You were supposed to be protected, but apparently somebody dropped the ball.
It's very complicated, sir. Yeah,
well, did you explain the situation?
Yeah, I did, yeah.
You show him the photographs?
Elena, Miles saw him yesterday.
What? So this is encounter number two?
I have to go.
I'm sorry, you're going where?
Where no one can find me.
How much did you not explain to this guy?
I thought I...
Listen, Colonel, I understand your desire to run for cover, and normally I wouldn't care, but I got orders from the White House to find General Romano and get him out of the country before he's assassinated. Guess what my orders are regarding you? Use to locate Romano. Meaning, if you don't help me, you're on your own.
I like being on my own.
Good. Well, now, let me give you the official government definition of on your own. I will paint a target on your head. I will give every scrap of information I have on you to the people who just blew up your car. I will see you dead by sunset.
All right, that's it.
Look, I will do the same thing to you, Chapel. It's General Romano we want. Someplace warm and sipping drinks. Deliver him, everybody dies, old and happy. If not, well, then it's Ali Ali oxen free.
I don't know where Romano is. When your people brought us in, we purchased new identities. We separated. It's been 8 years.
Well, then start with the last place you saw. You got 24 hours.
Listen, I'm sorry. I should have warned you. I hate that guy.
Yes, I'm quite familiar with this type.
What do you want to do?
Same as you, I want to die old.
Yeah.
How's your roommate?
Hanging in, you?
Getting close.
Do you have a home alarm system?
Yeah, Diamante Security. Why?
I'd switch. Managing director's on his way out.
Ponce? Well, they were on my list of budget cuts anyway, along with food.
Yeah,
I guess I'll talk to you about that later.
Can I talk to him?
He hung up. He does that.
How do you know this guy, Krendel?
When General Romano and I arrived in this country, we realized that the State Department's red carpet only stretched so far. So, Krendel, he took care of certain details of settling into your country for a price.
Must have been hard adjusting to civilization.
You call this country civilized?
We got fast food, cheap cable, and good toilets.
Civilization is obedience. This country, it's too much freedom, too many opinions, too many arguments, night and day.
Yeah, democracy's a bitch.
You want me to trust this guy? He smells like a fed.
You trust me, don't you?
Pal, I hardly knew you. That was a long time ago, in the jungle, far, far away.
When General Romano and I reached out to you to purchase new identities, it was because you were not attached to any government. Your loyalty was to Romano and Romano only.
Damn straight. General saved my life back in 89. Whole village went nuts. A weapon jams up. Have you ever been beaten half to death by wooden rakes?
I sat through the English patient.
Man, Romano. He dumped so many rounds into them farmers you couldn't tell asses from elbows. Now I'm supposed to just give him up because you say I gotta? I beg to differ.
My associate and I were just saying, that is the problem. Too much difference of opinion, not enough obedience.
Man, this is my place.
When you have told us what we need to know, where Romano is.
Liquor license.
What?
He thought it might be fun to own a bar. Cat was into Casablanca, man. I'm gonna be Bogart, but with strippers.
What name did you sell?
Tomas. Enrique Tomas.
And the funny thing about tea, you don't own it, you just rent it.
You're all back. Wrong, Brooke. And you need to sleep it off. Not if I move to myself and to you. It's a strange life I saw. I'm hurt about it.
Oh, wow, isn't it? Elena?
Then I'm crazy.
Elena?
And I should be.
Car's out front, ma'am.
Elena?
Just get the revolver.
Elena!
We're going hunting, remember? Let's go.
Check on all the booze tickets that were issued the month Romano got his new name.
Yeah, Mr. Melvoy, that sounds like a good idea. Sir? You wanna what?
What?
You want to talk to Colonel Ponce?
I do.
You want to tell him to be ready to
get out of Dodge tonight if we find
General Romano?
You don't have to be so abusive. Sir, he's sitting right here. Tell him yourself. All right, hold on.
Yes.
Colonel, Melboy here. We just wanted to make sure that you have everything with you that you want to have when you leave with us.
I travel light, Mr. Melboy. Don't worry.
Where to?
My office.
Dave, we are not talking about clients or deadlines here. What I need is very simple. You told me if I ever needed a gun, you could get me one. Well, I need one. Now. Come on. Hey. Someone want to rescue me? Now? Please?
Anybody in there?
Yes, let me out. Hurry!
Okay. Don't panic. I'll get the pass.
You know, you did a pretty nice job with that Crandall guy. I bet his ears are still ringing.
Thank you.
Somebody coming. Look, get what you came here for.
Hey, hey, hey. I'll take care of her in the basement.
You had him. He was yours.
Yeah, mine. Yeah. What about Roberto Mardon? Luis Peña. Maria Zostra. Caterina Rosa. Alba Frisia. Esteban Corsa.
What about them?
They lost families, too.
I don't understand.
I'm not always very good about explaining things. But I think I know what you want. I figured out a way for you to get it, to keep you safe. You'll be involved, Elena, along with the rest of the survivors.
But in what?
In what you've all been fighting for. The right to be heard. Just hang with me a little bit longer, I promise. You'll all be heard from. Loud and clear. Trust me. Yeah.
Elena got away.
No kidding.
I don't know what she's gonna do.
Me neither. Elena, what are you going to do?
She's there.
KC, hold the line.
Listen, what's it going to be? You can walk away now or stay with me and see this through all the way.
I'll see it through all the way.
KC?
Everything's going to be fine.
You wait for me at the motel? Wait, one more thing. I need your shoe. Gee, you know, I sure did like that little girl. even though I only knew her for those last few seconds. She had spunk. Nice perfume. And great shoes. You know, it's kind of funny. If I would have met her a month ago or a couple hours from now, things might have been different. Ah, probably not. Women, you know. When it comes to guys like me, it always ends up near some incinerator holding footwear. Beats alimony. Let's see what the pinhead found.
Melboy here.
You got an address yet on Romano's alias?
Yeah, the alias corresponds to a liquor license that was granted to a business called...
the Triple X Ranch.
Uh-huh. This guy's got some kind of life.
Got a home address?
Yeah. Want us to try the bar first?
Do I?
What are you doing?
I have no idea.
His house?
Well, I'm going to Romano's house.
Sounds like a good idea to me.
Listen, if we strike out over here, we'll meet you there.
Otherwise?
If I don't see you there, I'll see you at the bar.
Lovely.
You all right? You sound funny.
I'm just fine.
For a place like this to be closed, isn't it? Make you nervous?
Very.
You know who I am?
Yeah, they do. If I was still alive. Easy on the gas. She's a guzzler.
Senor Prendel was kind enough to warn me you were coming.
Hello, Coronel. Good to see you again. Jorge Nando, you better get back to the club, see that we don't have any other visitors. Carlos, you stay here with me. And take off the... get our guests some iced tea. My garden, so delicate. The night air can be very bitter this time of year. I want to stand here and warm every leaf, every flower, but I know from experience some will live, some will die. And the garden goes on.
Shall we?
Forgive the remodel, supposed to be done a month ago. I could kill that contractor.
Looks like it's gonna be a classy place. Better than those downtown strip clubs of yours.
What we do for business is not who we are or even what we wish to become. Who is this man, Ponce?
Era un consejero. Estaba allá. De nuestra parte. Con el Departamento de Estado.
And?
Hay fanáticos. Cazando.
The only hunters I see are you two.
There have been three attacks on my life. It's not safe. We have come down to warn you. The State Department will help us get out.
The same State Department got us in. Well, that's very confusing.
They're concerned for you, for me. They told me to come down and warn you.
Well, then you've done your job. I thank you. After your tea, Coronel, you will leave in the same manner you arrived. If I see or hear from either of you again, I will have you killed.
You will not see me again, General. I had a mission to find you, and I found you, and this comes from the White House.
Well, that in itself gives me pause, since I no longer have friends in the White House. But let's say I have enemies in the U.S., mopping offices by night, stalking me by day. I have dealt with this kind of trash my whole life. I'm well hidden, well protected, and if these people exist, I will find them first. Their families and their children. Remember, it was your government who trained us, who said to use the children to stop the men. Ponce could tell you that I like using children. I miss it, actually.
What do you do when you find a man who doesn't have any children?
That man you eliminate.
Yeah, if
You can see him coming.
I always have.
Get out!
Boy, I told you I never liked that guy.
Why?
You brought him here.
I don't know.
All right, all right, all right. Play nice, boys, or you both drown me. Let him go. Daryl, you were right. Me and Ponce, we brought him in together. The government wants us all dead.
Why?
Policy changes every 5 minutes. Who knows, maybe CIA decided to clean house and with the embarrassment of the week. Melboy was scum, but he was Washington scum. Now he's dead in your house. You got a situation here. You want to take on the whole government by yourself? Be my guest. Ponce, you coming?
No, wait.
I know a guy who's got a plane. We can be out in 30 minutes.
What about my safety?
What do you need, a program? The but game is over.
I have money. I'll pay you, both of you.
You got no time for your banks.
No, I have it here. I'll get it.
I said we leave him. This guy's rude. It's up to you.
Coronel.
Of course, General.
Range on this friend's plane.
I figure we can make it across the Pacific to Myanmar. We can bribe our way in. No extradition. Hey. We're on the way. Ready?
Ready.
Aboard. Make yourselves comfortable. You'll be taking off in a moment.
Don't you mean we will be taking off?
Actually, no. There will, however, be a lot of familiar faces on board. Because, General and Colonel, this is your life. I'm your host, Ralph Edwards, and I'm sure you'll recognize your captain, Roberto Mardan. Some other passengers this evening.
Esteban Corsa.
Carmen Rojas. Luis Peña. Caterina Rosa. Alba Fresca.
I'm sure you recognize the rest. And my lovely co-host, Elena Amayo. Come a long way. In fact, from the dead. These folks have gone to a considerable amount of trouble to be here tonight, and they'd love to sit around and talk about old times, but this is kind of a pricey reunion, and I'm sure you both can afford it. Is that enough?
Yes, thank you. We can handle it from here.
You can't do this. We have rights.
Yeah, you have the right to face the people you destroyed. You have a right to admit your guilt. You even have a right to beg for mercy.
One thing that you don't have the right to is parachutes. I heard there was peanuts on board, though, and I believe they're honey roasted. Adios.
Are concerned, we agreed to start a relief fund for other survivors. On the flight, all of us took a very democratic vote. We decided to return Ponce and Romano to El Salvador. Huh. Or maybe it was Nicaragua. Hard to tell from 10,000 feet.
Yeah.
Now that's tough love.
Whoa.
So how are you doing money-wise?
Same. Well, worse. Kinda.
I love this room. I even stay down here myself sometimes. Wanna know why?
It's not like there's one quirk that really stands out. Why?
Next on Vengeance Unlimited.
It's an ugly crime you're talking about. GIs involved.
There's no way to get these guys.
Well, already.
You are so sick.
I had my fingers crossed the whole time. The entire time.